Andrew Wasson from CreativeGuitarStudio.com. Today I'm going to show you a trick to build scale patterns along the neck without using any of the standard scale layouts commonly shown in guitar textbooks. The best part is that with this trick, I can cover the entire fingerboard and still end up with scale shapes that are highly functional, use every note of the key, and sit perfectly on the neck for the easiest scale and guitar soloing layouts. And that's what we're going to do here in the YouTube lesson. Now, if you join me on Patreon for the second half of this lesson, you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'll switch over to chords and harmony, taking what we learned from playing scales and melody into the world of rhythm guitar. We'll look at how chords work in these neck areas, and we'll apply all this stuff into a chord progression that uses these tricks with chord harmony to create a two-part progression that includes some awesome sounding licks. Let's begin with a couple of scale and note shapes that will show how this trick works on guitar. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the CreativeGuitarStudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to CreativeGuitarStudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. The best part about this scale trick that I have for you today is that it's very simple to understand. All you need to do is visualize the guitar neck in two parts. One lower half is from the open strings up to the 7th fret area, and then the upper half would be from the 7th fret all the way up to 12th. You could go further, but you know, 12th, 14th, 15th, something like that. If we take any note, let's say for example an E, like an open 6th string E, and we started to plot it out across the neck, we would end up with two scale locations, you know, one in the lower half and one in the upper half. You can plot notes out easy enough by just thinking in terms of octaves. Just like that. And then just, you know, cut the neck at the 7th fret and think of it as we have some octave ideas that are located down in this region, and then, you know, past the 7th fret, we can look, you know, forward to other octaves that can exist up here. So, you know, once you do that, you can start forming some scale systems, and you can become aware of the note locations and create two or more scale shapes within each of the regions. So let's say that, you know, for instance, that I started down low here, and I went through some tones of E minor scale. I could take those tones past the 7th fret just as easy. And they're all the same notes, we've just taken them up an octave. So we had them down here, and then we just shifted them up past the 7th fret with the same notes. And you can do the same thing up in another octave range. You could go to that secondary octave range of, you know, between open to 7th and create a new pattern for a scale of E minor. And then you can take that and play it up past the 7th fret and have a new octave range there. Or you could, you know, isolate the ranges. Like you could have, you know, something from the first range that you played and, you know, have it, you know, set up off 7th fret to 12th. And keep that going. Just like that, really nice sound. You could do the same thing off that really low one that I started with from the open 6th string. You notice now what I'm doing with these is I'm staying in the low region entirely. And so this can be super helpful, like regardless of what you're doing. If you're building scales and trying to understand them on the guitar, maybe you're trying to, you know, formulate licks and have one lick idea that's in one region and then take it to another. Or you could also branch out to chords, which is what we're going to do in the Patreon lesson. You can take some chord shapes that you would have in one region of the neck and then move them to other areas, you know, and keep them in the same range. It's up to you on how you want to set them up on the guitar. We're going to cover all that stuff in the second half of this lesson when we hit the Patreon section, because I really think once you can combine scales and chords with this philosophy, it's really strong for you in terms of how you understand your guitar fingerboard. It's just great stuff. So we're going to take a short break, and then I'm going to come back with some licks for you so you can understand how to do some pattern playing with some guitar licks and then move them, you know, all across the guitar neck. and seeing the next split, you know, from that seventh fret area. Another really cool thing about this idea of using the seventh fret to create a borderline on your guitar neck is that when you play licks, riffs, or melody lines that get established in one region, they can also easily get transferred over to the other region. Now, to go and demonstrate that to you, I've created a melodic idea and I've placed it into each of the regions. This lick all shares the same layout, it's just like the scale patterns did. So when you learn one of them, learning the others is going to be a piece of cake. Let me demonstrate this to you so you understand exactly how it works. Let's get started by playing the lick down so you understand what it sounds like. Now, as you can tell, it's really the same lick. I'm just playing it through the different position layouts, just like we did with the scales earlier on. So the first lick that we have, it's set up in the low position from the sixth string open. Obviously the lowest one that we have. And then from that setup, I just went to the next octave past the seventh fret to set it up again. You know, one of the really nice areas to play licks, runs, guitar solos is between 7th and 12th, so you might even find that that particular region of the neck is super comfortable for you, especially if you've, you know, been doing some soloing in that, you know, so far. Now, coming around with the lick, staying in the same register, we can set it up again, but this time, you know, back between open and 7th fret. You notice it's very bright in there because, you know, with that layout, we've got long guitar strings. You know, we're starting from 2nd fret instead of with that same note being on 7th over here. You notice that it doesn't have the same brightness. There's a sort of a range of sound that changes when you play these ideas in different positions. Now, our final layout that we have is up quite high. And that's our highest octave that we're dealing with in this case, because, you know, if you really think about it, the one down here, this is our lowest octave. And then if we were just to stay around 2nd fret position, those notes are the same as 7th. But again, the real difference there is the difference in the tonal range. Like, we just have this different impact of sound. But when we go up here, we're in a brand new octave range. So this is another great experience if you've never gone and broken ideas down before. You can tell, you know, we can have different octave ranges, but we can also have a different sound by way of the contrast of the length and the diameter of the guitar strings. And that feeds into this whole thing of unison work. You know, if you play it, you know, out of the second position here, and then you play it again, but in 7th off 5th string, you know, it's the same notes, but what we're doing is we're just playing them in another area where we have different lengths of strings and the strings change in diameter. You know, when you have more strings, let's say, that are wound as compared to strings that are not wound, then, you know, again, you get a different color of the sound of the notes. And sometimes that's going to fit in the song that you're composing or for the solo that you're trying to put together on the neck for your band. But maybe other times it just doesn't. And that's why you need the flexibility of being able to control that. Whereas, though, you've got to think of it in another way. If you're playing really low like this, you're kind of just jammed out to just that range because some of those notes, they don't have other unisons in other positions, especially, of course, the 6th string open there. That's the only one we got, unless you had a 7th string guitar or something like that. But, you know, these are just things that you need to think about and be aware of, and the split that we can do to analyze the guitar setup off of open to 7th, and then from 7th to at least 12th, or maybe a little bit further than that, maybe 14th or 15th. It's going to give you the awareness to be able to work with these concepts. Now, we've been doing a lot of this work, obviously, here in the YouTube video with scales and, you know, that stuff and licks. But what I want to do next is when we move over to the Patreon lesson, I'm going to shift this work over to the world of chords because I want you to understand also how this works with chords. But the real bonus of the Patreon lesson is going to be a chord progression that I put together for you, like a rhythm guitar jam, but it's going to include a couple of filler licks using some of the principles of the scales that we've gone over here. So I hope to see you next in the Patreon lesson for the second half of this exercise that we're doing, because this is some really fantastic stuff, very valuable stuff, and it's going to expand your horizons of the guitar neck like crazy. So I'll catch up with you next on Patreon. If you're one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video where we'll make the shift over to chords with what we've learned from playing scales and melody in the lower and upper fretboard regions of the neck. First, what we're going to do is look at how chords can function in these two areas, and then we'll apply all of this over a riff-based chord progression that uses the scale ideas along with the chords to create a really cool sounding two-part progression that also has some great filler licks. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get all the jam tracks and you'll be able to download a detailed PDF handout that shows you all the examples in both music notation and tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members' discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.